this is Black Mesa. This is an unrelenting game that will punish you severely for repeated use of a single weapon. It demands you use multiple weapons. Understand each weapon's strengths and weaknesses, as well as your enemies. Because if you don't, you die. It is my favorite game on Steam because it demands the use of one's brain. Now this is Fallout 4. This game is drastically easier. You can get away with using a single weapon the entire game because you can repeatedly upgrade said weapon. So you can get to the point where you shred giant lizards to death. So how did I make this Fallout 4 among my favorites along with Black Mesa? Well, that's how I made this monstrosity. Mod after mod after mod. There are many mods that I've used since the beginning, and many more that I have since forgotten about. So, I thought I'd go through a nice long playthrough of my modded Fallout 4, where I turned it into survival horror. Resources are extremely scarce. Bullets matter. Every single one counts. And medicine? Good luck getting that shit. So join me as I take a nice walkthrough through the Fallout 4 that I myself have modded to my own taste. I think it's perfect. Making my head was a little bit tricky. I can't get it round enough. And only to get a round enough head, I need to be a woman. As for my lover, well, I based her on somebody I used to know. She was a nice girl. Moving on.
Hey, hon.
Why don't you see if breakfast is ready?
Right. Moving on, I went over to my baby boy, who's resting nicely. Look at him. He's so cute. I'm gonna spin this thing.
Wonder what Sean will grow up to be.
Yeah, I wonder.
Ah, good morning, sir.
Good morning.
173.5 degrees Fahrenheit. Road to perfection.
Oh, it seems like Codsworth is trying to kill me.
Thanks, Codsworth.
Of course, sir. Now, sounds like someone made a stick. I shall attend to young Sean.
You know, I was nervous at first, but Codsworth's really good with Sean.
Hun.
Can't believe it's almost Halloween. Oh, need to finish making Sean's costume.
Hell, bitch, it's March!
Can you get that? It's probably that salesman. He comes for you every
day. Yeah, either that or the IRS. Can't be too bad.
Good morning! Vault-Tec calling.
Good morning.
Isn't it? Just look at that sky out there. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, sir, this country has gone to in a handbasket, if you'll excuse my language. The big kaboom. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family's service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
I'm a little busy right now.
Oh, of course, of course. This won't take but a moment. It's just a matter of verifying some information. Need to make sure you're cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of, total atomic annihilation.
Come back some other time.
Come on, hon. It's just a little paperwork. Let him fill it out, and it's done.
Come on. You really think it could happen? Nuclear war?
Of course not, but look, we have Sean to think of now. Sean. Sean. Sean.
You're right.
Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Mr. Hammer, Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that paternal affection you seem to be so good at.
You heard Codsworth. Go on.
Paternal affection, my ass. He needs a breakfast.
Sugar bombs. 100% daily value of sugar.
Okay, never mind. Keep him as far away from that as possible.
How are the two most important men in my life doing? Spin the mobile a bit. He loves that.
Don't have to tell me twice.
Hey, how's my little guy? Much better now, huh? Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Ooh, is this a romantic park?
And do what exactly?
Sir? Mom? You should come and see this!
Codsworth? What's wrong?
What is there, a pigeon on the roof? Come on, Codsworth, can't you see I'm trying to get frisky with my wife?
Followed by... yes, followed by flashes, blinding flashes. Sounds of explosions.
Hey,
sir, we're trying to get confirmation. Seem to have lost contact with
saying?
Our affiliate stations. We do have coming in. That's confirmed reports. I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania.
My God.
Oh my God.
We need to get to the vault now.
I've got Sean. Let's go.
Codsworth, stay safe, buddy.
And your family as well, sir.
Return home!
We're gonna die out here!
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant, adult male, adult female. Okay,
thank
good.
You.
Good luck, ma'am.
Gotta go,
you two, follow me! Come on!
What's this?
All right, that's it. Set it down.
Almost there. We're gonna be okay. I love you.
We
both
love
of
you, too.
Oh, my God!
Hold on!
Oh God! Oh God! Oh God! We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Everyone, please step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future.
So we just...
underground.
Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. If we left a minute later...
No. Don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now. Everyone, just
everything
head up
okay?
These stairs.
It's gonna be okay, right?
Hey.
Please, up the stairs. Head up the stairs. Got a lot to do to get you oriented.
All new residents,
male.
Please proceed in an orderly fashion.
Female and infant.
Welcome.
Hey.
Sir. Move along.
Just step over to
each
the table.
Each of you take one of these. Your brand new vault suits. It's down
Thanks.
The hallway right there.
What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
See?
Hey there.
Down that
this
hallway.
Is our new home.
They'll show
oh,
you where to go.
Oh, you're gonna love it here. It's gone. Our home. Everything.
Nothing to see here.
Mother and father down in D.C. Oh, God, honey.
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get.
Just checking everyone off the list as they come in.
As well as comfortable.
Prepared for the future, right?
Hey there.
Just step in here and put your vault suit on. Just step into the chamber.
Shh. It'll be okay. Daddy's right here. See? Honey, could you help me?
Who's my little guy? I'm not going far. I'll just be over there.
There he is. See? Daddy's not going far.
All set? Just step inside and put on your vault suit.
Hey, hon.
Go ahead, hon. I'll take Sean with me.
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Time for a whole new life.
Your release! Come on, come on, come on! Oh, God!
I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back. I promise.
All the residents must vacate.
Goodbye, my love. Seems like everybody here is deceased. What in the fuck? You're gonna be a good boy. Nope, he's a bad boy. He is a bad, bad boy.
Giant roaches? What the hell?
Well, I suppose it's better than my bare hands. Now, real quick, I want to point out, yes, this is an M1911, and no, I'm not going to pick it up. This is an unintended side effect of a mod. It places its own weapons all over the map.
Is this all that's left?
But I don't want to grab them. I want them to be a reward for later down the line. Now, I'd also like to point out that I usually play this game on a controller, but OBS doesn't record sound if I plug in a PS controller, so you're just gonna watch me struggle to adapt to a keyboard. And now we find my greatest asset, better than any gun I could have. This is a Pip-Boy, also known as the game menu. Can't play the game if you don't have a fucking menu. And now with our Pip-Boy in hand, we can open the vault back into the outside world. And now we return to the surface. Oh, how I missed you, my nuclear way. Don't mind that crash vertebrate, that's... Alright, I'm just gonna shut the hell up. While I'm here in Paranoid, I'll go ahead and configure all the settings to make my survival horror experience more survival horror. Man. It's hard to believe that this used to be a place that I lived in. Hold up a second. Codsworth, my servant!
Codsworth. What happened to the world?
World, sir? Well, besides our geranium still being the envy of Sanctuary Hills, I'm afraid things have been dreadfully dull.
Things will be so much more exciting with you and Mrs. Beck. Where is your better half, by the by?
She's... in a better place.
Sir, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire...
It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades.
Sean does so love that game. Is the lad with you?
Sean's been kidnapped. But I'm going to find him. I'm going to get my son back.
It's worse than I thought. Mm-hmm. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia.
What?
You're two centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack? You must be famished.
Codsworth, you're acting a little weird. What's wrong?
Oh, sir, it's been just horrible. Two centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve.
I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. And nothing.
Don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car! The car!
Stay with me, pal. Focus.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, sir. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were dead.
I did find this holotape. I believe the missus was going to present it to you as a surprise. But then, well, everything happened.
Thank you, Codsworth.
You're welcome. Now, enough feeling sorry for myself. Shall we search the neighborhood together?
What would be the point? I know that my wife is dead and my son has been kidnapped.
I don't know, Codsworth.
Follow me.
Great. Codsworth basically just said, fuck you. Well, I guess it gives me time to go over memories.
Oopsie. No. Fingers away. There we go. Okay, just see it. Right there. Yay. Hi, honey. Listen, I don't think that Sean and I need to tell you how great of a father you are. But we're going to anyway. Isn't that right? You are kind and loving. Funny. That's right. And patient. So patient. Patience of a saint, my mom used to say. Look, with Sean and us all being home together, it's been an amazing year. But even so, I know our best days are yet to come. There'll be changes, sure. Things we need to adjust to.
I'm coming, buddy.
We're joining the civilian workforce, no matter how hard. I'll shake the dust off my lodge, we'll do it for our family. Now, say goodbye, Sean. Bye-bye. Say bye-bye. Come on. Bye, honey. We love you.
Excuse me, what?
Mr. Erectus, the Mrs. and young Sean, they aren't here.
Come on, Codsworth. I need your help. Where can I go?
You could head into the city. Concord is nearby. But the people there are as put together as I am.
There's still people alive in Concord?
Yes, although they're a bit rough. You remember the way?
All right. Too easy. Just head over to Concord. Now we head over to Concord and... oh, what's this? A trash bin with grenades. This can't be a coincidence. Oh, what's this? Some people. Well, I guess we could see if we could get a good barter out of the... oh shit, they just broke my leg in an instant. Oh my... Yeah. This is where the game ramps up a bit. Guns in this are hyper lethal, but that does go both ways. The biggest issue is that firearms can cause open wounds, which will just drain your health. So with this, you gotta use every advantage you can, or else you die.
Fuck, I hit the wrong button. I'm bleeding and I'm on fire. I'm just gonna set my fate. Headshot, that's a good start, that's a good start. Oh my god! This is what's really fucked about this mod pack. Alright, there's a 50-50 shot, the guns they have will just break. And then you can't even pick them up. But every now and then, it does. It is complete. Look at that. It looks like ass, doesn't it? That's because it is. But you know what? It's got bullets.
Moving on from that nightmare. I find a dog. I draw a gun on it because I think it might try to bite me.
Boy, what are you doing out here all by yourself?
Sounds like a good boy.
You lose your
now that I have a dog on my side, I head on into this building with confidence. And, of course, it's never that easy. God damn it, fucking rats! Once I kill the rats, I go ahead and make me some of these hunting kits. Which will allow me to extract meat, bones, and skin from all these rats. And then I squeeze radiation out of that meat. It gives me less meat in the end, but I don't have to deal with radiation sickness. And then I run into some fucking mosquitoes. I then make it to my destination. Conquered! Where I am greeted with gunfire. And also this soldier looking lady, who seems to have forgotten her gun. Well, I've pretty much become an asshole at this point because I just kill her immediately, take her armor, and find that she did have a gun, but she didn't have the correct ammo on her person. Oh well. Survival of the fittest, I guess. Then, moving into Concord, I learned from my bridge experience to use shadows as my ally. I do not engage until I know I can get a clean headshot on the opponent. Oh shit. That was close.
Hey, up here, on the balcony. I've got a group of settlers inside. The raiders are almost through the door. Grab that laser musket and help us, please!
Well, he hasn't shot me on sight, so I guess he can be a friend. As my weapon arsenal grows, my confidence grows with it. I start getting better and better at one-shot headshots. I start thinking, you know, maybe this ain't so tough. Get reminded.
See, as you can see, the more you fuck around, the more you're gonna find out.
Yeah,
shotguns in this mod pack are genuinely busted. Limbs just go flying off.
Come on!
Man, I don't know who you are, but your time is impeccable. Preston Garvey, Commonwealth Minuteman.
I'm just passing through.
Fair enough. But the enemy of my enemy is my friend, right? And those raiders want us all dead, including you.
God damn it.
The world's changed so much. None of this makes sense.
All right. Listen, we need your help.
Nope.
And then maybe we can help you, huh? What brought you out here?
Looking for an infant boy. He's been kidnapped.
Yours or tracking for someone else? Used to be a lot of families in this group. More than a few missing relatives. A month ago, there were 20 of us. Yesterday, there were 8. Now we're 5. First, it was the ghouls in Lexington, and now this mess.
Sorry. Sounds rough.
God damn it.
Thanks. It's good to meet someone who really cares. Anyway, we figured Concord would be a safe place to settle. Those raiders proved us wrong. But, well, we do have one idea.
Let's hear it.
Sturgis, tell him.
There's a crashed vertebrate up on the roof. Old school, pre-war. You might have seen it.
Well, looks like one of its passengers left behind a seriously sweet goodie. We're talking a full suit of Cherry T-45 power armor. Military issue.
That's some serious protection.
Oh, it gets better. Get the suit. You can rip the minigun right off the vertibird. Do that, and those raiders get an express ticket to hell. You dig?
Huh. Could work.
It'll work, provided we can reactivate the suit. It's totally out of juice. Probably has been for 100 years.
It can be powered up again. But we're a bit stuck.
So, what's the solution?
What you'll need is an old pre-war FC. A standardized fusion core. Your high-grade, long-term nuclear battery used by the military and some companies way back when.
But we can't get to the damn thing. It's down in the basement. Locked behind a security gate.
Look, I fix stuff. I tinker. Bypassing security ain't exactly my forte. You could give it a shot.
Can't be too hard. I'll see what I can do.
Well, all right. Maybe our luck's finally turning around. Once you jack the core into the power armor and grab that minigun, those raiders will know they picked the wrong fight. Good luck.
Now, some power armor is exactly what I need, because power armor prevents bleeding.
You plan on dying today? No? Then move it!
Now look who dog meat brought to us.
Hello, old lady.
So, he's your dog?
He ain't my dog. No, sir. Dog meat, he's what you call his own man. You can't own a free spirit like that. But he chooses his friends and sticks with them. He'll stay by you now. I saw it.
Visions. Uh-huh.
I know what you're thinking. This old lady, she's out of her mind. But it's the chems. They give old Mama Murphy the sight.
What's the sight?
I can see a bit of what was and what will be. And even what is right now. And right now, I can see this something coming, drawn by the noise and the chaos, and it is angry.
What is it? Mama Murphy, I need more, please.
I see. Oh, it's horrible, kid. Claws and teeth and horns. The very face of death itself.
That's all I can manage. That's all.
I need to rest now. And you have a job to do.
Well, that was slightly mortifying.
You're with the rescue team?
Oh God, why?
God.
Hey.
There are more
of you. What kind of community have I stumbled onto?
Oh shit, okay, I got stuck. Don't worry. This is why I play on PC. There we go. All better now. Here we are. With our nice suit of power armor. Don't ask for the footage of where I got in it. It had to go back to its home planet.
Show me that fancy gun up close. Not a lot of people can get past my boys. Give me that!
Y'all idiots, but I'm gonna keep hiding here like a pussy. Alright, I don't know where that claw of death went, but it looks like I'm in the clear for now. Oh no! Shit, he's taking a lot of damage. Bleeding applies to him too! Oh hell yes! I fucking did it. I slayed the lizard. Oh, you little shit's got nothing. You got nothing. And to think that I was once getting stomped by three guys across from a bridge. Yeah, pretty fitting that once I stop the fight, the sun starts to come out.
That was a pretty amazing display. I'm just glad you're on our side.
You guys gonna be okay now?
Yeah, for a while anyway. We can... Listen, when we first met, you said you were just passing through. Well, maybe this'll help you reconsider. Ain't much, but it's the best we can do. And you've earned it.
You're welcome. Anytime.
Well, since you say that, maybe you'll come to Sanctuary with us. We could use your help getting settled there.
What would I need to do?
You'd need to stay strong like you've been. Cause there's more to your destiny. I've seen it. And I know your pain.
My destiny? What do you mean?
You're a man out of time. Out of hope. But all's not lost. I can feel your son's energy. He's alive.
Where is my son? Where is Sean?
Oh, I wish I knew, kid. I really do. But it's not like I can see your son. I can just feel his life force, his energy. And I don't need the sight to tell you where you should start looking. The great green jewel of the Commonwealth. Diamond City. The biggest settlement around.
That's vague.
Look, kid. I'm tired now. Maybe you'll bring me some chems later. The sight will paint a clearer picture.
Mama Murphy, we talked about this. That junk. It's gonna
kill
you.
Preston. We're all gonna die eventually. We're gonna need the sight. And our new friend here, he's gonna need it too.
Let's get going. Sanctuary awaits.
All right, folks. Thanks to our friend here, it's safe to move out. We're heading for that place Mama Murphy knows about. Sanctuary. It's not
she
far.
She knows about it? You mean she had one of her visions while she was stoned out of her gourd? And now you want us to just head out on another wild goose chase based on no better plan than Mama Murphy?
Oh, hold on. Worse than...
Everybody just take it easy.
We're all in this together, right?
So, Marcy, you got a better idea of what we should do next? Anybody? Well then, sanctuary it is. Let's just hope it lives up to its name.
Come on, June.
I think I've got a lot of work ahead of me. Never did I think I'd ever have the motivation to make a 40-minute video. That was a lot of fun, actually.